continue the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Utah State is kicking off first, and we're ready to get this game underway. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Makes it to the 37.
Super effort by the tailback to pick up a nice gain and a first down. He's really a good-looking ball carrier.
He's taken down around the 49-yard line.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air with a play-action pass.
And he's tackled at the 43-yard line.
Gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and two.
Gets out to around the 32. And that's their third first down of the drive.
The defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
Tackle at the 26-yard line. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. Slides down to the ground. It's first and 10. Ball on the 16. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. He's tackled at the 11. Strike to the receiver. They'll bring him down around the 7-yard line. It's the 9th play of the drive. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals. And he hits him hard at the 16-yard line.
It's a big-time effort sacked by the defensive end. I want to also give some credit to the coverage downfield. The end never gave up on the play, but because the quarterback didn't have anywhere to go with the football, it gave the defensive end enough time to eventually chase the quarterback down for that sack.
It's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here. The Sooners quarterback down on the sideline after getting injured earlier. I don't think it looks like he's in that much pain, and I would bet that we're going to see him back in the game before the day's over. And it sails through the uprights. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Quick throw. He gets hit out of bounds around the 35-yard line. And they make the stop at about the 45.
Second and
gets him open field. Brought down
around the 40-yard line.
You talk about a dual-threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
Looks to him again, complete. Tackle made around the 29-yard line. From the 29-yard line, first down. Gives it to the back. Runs outside for a nice game. He's taken down at about the 23-yard line. This is the eighth play of the drive. So the Aggies wideout out with an apparent injury, although he might make a comeback before this game's over. Complete. It's the junior, and down he goes at about the 11.
What a relief it is for a quarterback to know that he's got a receiver like this who can step up when he needs him on third down. Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
Here's play number 10 on the drive.
Good discipline here by the defense, stringing the option out and plugging the running lanes. That moved them back.
Third and long here, and they hope to convert another one and keep this drive going. He's scrambling, fires across the middle. Almost picked off.
Man, I don't know if this quarterback misread the defense or just made a poor decision, but that wasn't a pass he should have thrown.
Utah State is down three and looking to tie it up. The kick is away. It's long enough, and he got it.
That one looked like cake for this kid. Chalk up 3 points for the offense.
3-3 tie. They line up to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. He makes it to the 28-yard line. Scrambling. That's a great tackle at the 33. So at the end of one, and this one's knotted up in three. We're all tied up, and more action coming, hopefully, here in quarter number two. Gets it. He's in space. Steps out of bounds at the 37. Fires out to his wideout, and he's level at the 50-yard line.
Number six. second down at the 35.
To see this, Brad. These cornerbacks have the toughest job in college football, and that's to cover some of the fastest players on the field and receivers. And for a corner willing to come up, get off of his block, and make a play to disrupt the run, that's as good as it gets if you're a defensive coordinator.
And they'll bring him down behind the line. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 25. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And he's finally knocked out of bounds at the 10-yard line. And he adds the extra point. So a 9-play, 74-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He gets out to about the 37-yard line. Quick pass, intercepted. And he tackles him hard at the 45-yard line.
Really nice cover skill shown here this time. That's exactly what you want to see from your young corner.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 45-yard line. Oklahoma up 7 points. There's a strike complete, and he's tackled at the 25-yard line.
Well, the quarterback's able to find a soft spot in the defense, and he threw an accurate ball for a solid pickup.
And they push him out around the 17-yard line. What a play to set him up with a first and goal. That makes it first and goal. Got his receiver, but it's knocked down.
I like the scheme the defensive coordinator came up with here. They were all over the place on that play and left the quarterback nowhere to throw it.
That brings up a second and goal. 1 yard to the goal line. Touchdown, Sooners.
I think the option down by the goal line is a great call. It puts so much pressure on the defense and allows the quarterback to have the decision to run it or pitch it. And this time it worked to perfection.
And he tacks on the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. the offense will take the field, and they're certainly hoping to do better than they did on their last drive, which ended with a turnover.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
On the ground with the tailback. And they get nice yardage on that run. Good tackle there in space. Fires it out. Tackle at the 49-yard line.
Number 31 makes the tackle at the 49-yard line. That brings him second and five.
He's going to try and scramble. He's tackled at the 39-yard line. Looks middle, got his back, and he is drilled to the 37-yard line. Third down now. They need to get it to the 29. They'll bring him down at about the 25-yard line.
When you can move the ball downfield in big chunks like that, you've got the defense right where you want it.
He scrambled, and he's going to be sacked for a loss.
That is a loss of 2 yards. That will bring up second and 12.
There's a player hurt. It doesn't look to be that bad.
Number 17.
Second down and 12. Ball on the 27. Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback. Slings it. Knocked out of bounds. Around the 24-yard line. 10th play of the drive. So the Aggies quarterback down there on the sideline, he was injured earlier. He means so much to this team. And right now, it looks like he's maybe going to be able to get back in the game. Doesn't look like he's in that much pain, so we'll hope so.
And they make the stop
around the 12-yard line.
It's a nice job here by the wide receiver of looking the ball in and keeping the chains moving. He was on the same page as his quarterback as they both saw the double outside linebacker blitz come.
He gets out to about the 9-yard line. And the halfback carries for a pickup of 3. Ball inside the 10-yard line. Second down. Tries to buy some time. He's got the corner, and he's going to run this one in. Touchdown.
Outstanding run and great execution by the entire offensive unit, especially the blocking up front.
He makes the PAT. It was a 12-play, 75-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
The score now is 17-10. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in 6. Oklahoma is up a score. At about the 29-yard line. Second and 6. Ball on the 29-yard line. Fires incomplete.
Boy, he put so much heat on that ball, I don't think anybody wanted to get their hands on that.
Pushed out of bounds
at about the 37-yard line.
From their own 37-yard line, first down. Caught, and this is going to be a first down. And he hits him hard at the 46-yard line.
He looked pretty cool back there. Even with the outside linebacker blitzing, he made an accurate throw, and the result is a new set of downs.
Finds his man, and they take him down immediately.
Oklahoma's going to have to use their second time out of the half.
From the 40-yard line, second down. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. Picked off.
This is a very well-coached defense. They know to get their hands up in the air and to try to knock down passes. Let's go,
let's go. Second and 10. Ball on the 33. Quick throw. Tackle made at the 5. Oklahoma is up 7. He's in trouble. Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown. And so he found his receiver for the score.
And the closer you get to the end zone, the more difficult it becomes to throw the football because the field becomes much smaller to work with. But they did a very nice job there to come up with the touchdown.
And the secondary didn't quite seem alert enough to defend that pass. And he hits the PAT. A 9-play, 74-yard drive. And it's good for 7 points.
You know, when you can throw the football as well as these guys can, you don't necessarily always have to have a balanced attack because you're so proficient throwing the ball.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
This is my kind of game. We're getting a chance to see so many touchdowns. I just wonder if this offense could continue the flow that we've seen from the previous three series. It's early in this game, so the defense can still have an opportunity to make some adjustments. But if things don't turn around in a hurry, it's really going to start to affect the psyche of that defensive line.
Quick throw, incomplete, wanted his receiver. And he let his receiver a little too much.
One of the things you look for when you have a young quarterback is how he releases the football. Here you can see he releases the ball a little bit early, a sign that he wasn't completely comfortable with what he was seeing.
Going right to his tailback. Brought down around the 26-yard line. He sails it long, and he's got the junior, and that tackle very well could have saved the touchdown.
So we've played 2 quarters. Oklahoma leads 24-10.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. I'm not sure many people saw that one coming. This team was supposed to take...
I thought this was your lock of the week, Reese Davis.
It was, and that shows you why I should leave the picking to you, because this was not a good selection. I didn't think there was any way that this team would come into halftime and be down by 2 scores.
Nobody did. I mean, I don't see how you got to this point. I don't even understand it. I don't understand what we just saw, and
We sit here all week and we break down strengths and weaknesses, and they're definitely better and stronger across the board, but they haven't found a way to put things together. And, you know, you get 30 minutes at the half. It's time to give the, you know, rally the troops speech and get everybody going and try to understand that you got to come out in the second half, and you can't be flat. You can't take this opponent for granted because you've already dug yourself a pretty big hole through the first half.
David and I will stay locked in on everything going on in college football. It's going to wrap it up here in the studio. Just about time to get you out to your second half. Brad and Kirk ready with a call.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Throws complete. He's got room to work. And down he goes, right around the 40.
That makes it first and 10.
Hey, Mike 20, Mike 20. Hey,
he's a 2-2. Got his man. Oh, what a hit. Scrambling. Throws incomplete.
You know, Brad, this is one of those plays where the quarterback just wants to apologize to the wide receiver, maybe every other member of this offense. But the wide receiver, if he's smart, will come up to that quarterback, tell him to forget about it. Let's move on to the next play.
He's scrambling. And he can't get away from the pressure. Defense hoping for another sack here on third and long. They keep it on the ground with the tailback. He's taken down at about the 47-yard line. About 2 yards there on that delayed handoff. They're trying to pin them deep with a solid punt right here. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. This offense has really seemingly been unstoppable. Should be interesting to see now if the defense has changed things up as they try to stop these guys. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. Taken down around the 37-yard line. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
Quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big game.
Tackled after a decent pickup.
Call it a gain of 4 yards. That makes it 2nd and 6.
Quick pass. He's at midfield. He gets hit out of bounds around the 47-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 36.
Kill, kill, kill! Five, 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 five.
at the 25. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. Got some open field. Up the middle for a nice gain. Goes out of bounds at the 18-yard line. And he's level at the 22.
When you're an option quarterback, you get used to getting popped pretty quickly. He'll bounce right back up.
Fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. Kicks away. And it's through the uprights. They line up to kick this one away. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Sooners continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in. From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Quick throw, almost intercepted.
You like a team that's ready to defend the pass. It takes some preparation to get in the way of a pass like that. Not a very impressive set of downs. Quarterback just doesn't seem to be throwing very confidently.
The punting team's got to give their kickers some time. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Pass incomplete. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 44-yard line. And they push him out around the 29-yard line. At the 20. Touchdown, Oklahoma. And he tacks on the extra point. With a three-play, 56-yard drive, and they get it in for seven.
And the big plays that they had running the football were the keys to that drive.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Utah State's having a hard time doing anything on offense right now.
Well, they've had some opportunities, but they either turn the ball over or obviously don't execute on third down, and they're forced to punt. Or their drive ends up stalling in a fourth down. But they're moving the ball at times. I think they've just got to take some chances at this point late in the game like this. Throw the ball downfield and hope that your receivers can make some plays.
He's tackled right around the 38-yard line.
That makes it first and 10. Three down, three down. Hey, Mike, 20.
scrambles. Tackle at the 47.
Well, they didn't pick up the first down, but he saw that no one was open, so he made the right decision to tuck it and run.
He's going to try and scramble. He gets sacked on the play. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. And they make the stop
at about the 33-yard line.
What a play.
Boy, solid job there by the quarterback, recognizing the defensive coverage and delivering the ball to the open receiver.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That'll bring up second.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. He's on the run. They'll bring him down around the 18-yard line. Maybe it's time to get the backup some experience as we head to the fourth quarter. The Sooners with a 24-point lead. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. He makes it to the 18-yard line. Tries to buy some time. What a play to set him up with a first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
Scrambling around. And he's going to run this one in. Touchdown. No one could break clear, so the QB decided to run it in.
You've got to like it when your leader takes things into his own hands, especially down inside the 10.
Well, they're going to try for the two-point conversion.
We won't come to our world.
Yeah, black
8. Mike 40, Mike
40. And the defense stops the ground game. No two-point conversion there. A 10-play, 76-yard drive, but the failed two-point conversion keeps it a 6-point score.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. That can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
And he just got stood up right there.
Boy, this is one of those days when everything is clicking for an offense. These guys have been executing, and that's the reason they have such a nice lead.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He steps out at the 35. He is drilled at the 23. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
That's a deal of four. That makes it 7-6.
Big play, and it's first and goal.
Let's go. Back five.
fires that quickly, incomplete. They're at the six. It's second down. Got his receiver, touchdown. Splits the uprights with the extra point. So that's a six-play, 39-yard drive. And they add 7 points to the scoreboard. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. And he's taken down at the 23-yard line.
I think any good football team has to have an ability to answer, and that's exactly what we just saw. One team scores a touchdown, the other team comes right back and puts another touchdown on the board. This is getting exciting.
And it'll be interesting to see how much fight this team has left in them. This has been a brutal game. Now he's scrambling. He's pushed out of bounds, right around the 34. He's scrambling. Fumble! It's scooped up by the offense. Not sure what the flag is about here. Let's go down to the field and find out.
Clipping. Offense.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
First and long now after the penalty. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Quick out to his receiver. Brought down at the 41-yard line. Less than 3 minutes in the game. There's a strike complete. Tackle made at the 43-yard line. And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five receiver look. They go back to him on a quick throw. It's picked up. And down he goes at the 46. That's a pretty big mistake, and this offense will lose possession of the football.
Sloppy job by the ball carrier. First and foremost, you should always be concerned about the ball.
The offense will take the field, and they've been moving the ball very well on their last couple of drives.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
Gets out to around the 35. It's first and 10. Ball on the 35. He makes his way to about the 18. From the 18-yard line, it's first down. Gains his way to the 10-yard line. That makes it second and two. Under a minute left in the game. There's another. Touchdown that we really don't care about. This game is still well out of reach. And he hits the PAT. So a four-play, 46-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. Oklahoma to kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 22-yard line. Late in the fourth quarter, this game's not even close. It's a blowout. A lot of folks have already gone home. And, Herbie, I think we're going to make our dinner reservation. Quick throw. He's taken down around the 33-yard line.
That's great execution. Quarterback made a nice throw, and the receiver was able to go up and make the play.
First and 10. Ball on their own 33. He gets out to about the 35-yard line. So the tailback gets 2 yards on the option. So the Aggies are going to call their second timeout. Throws this one out to the right. That's incomplete.
Sure, it's disappointing, but this is the kind of mechanical flaw you can fix with practice and coaching.
That'll bring up third and 8.
To go long and done. Well, the stop made there late in the fourth quarter, but this game's been over almost since the beginning. I think it's time for everybody to head to the locker room. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. Today we saw a game that wasn't even close. Oklahoma 48, Utah State 16. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.